Auto Shop, Auto Shop of Horrors, bop she bop. You'll never go. Sorry, wrong song, but it kind of fits. Hello, everyone. Welcome once again to the Final Cut in Indie. I know, indie horror comedies on the block. Big surprise here for the Final Cut, but we do have one for you today, and it is called Auto Shop of Horrors. Now, Auto Shop of Horrors is brought to us by Glenn Bergoitz and Tim Gallagher, who wrote and directed this story about a gentleman, Randy, who runs an auto shop, and he has people show up, but, well, they check their car in, but they don't exactly leave in the same condition that they were when they got to the auto shop. You see, because Randy has this belief from the Mayans that if you eat the eyes of people, you can foresee the future. And, well, you can see where this goes. These individuals unsuspectedly walk into the trap of the spider, and the spider then proceeds to dispatch them in evil, mean, and nasty ways and cover his tracks. But he does have a detective on his trail who is starting to look into things a little bit closer into this auto shop of horrors. This is a lot of fun. Glenn Bergoitz plays, and I hope I pronounced that right. If not, I do apologize. Is playing a Randy character, and he's really into this role. He's having a lot of fun with it. Paul Roher, he plays the detective in here, and I enjoyed his character as well. He shows up a little bit later, though, in the film, but when he does, he plays off with Andy very well. He felt kind of like a detective, you know, caught into, unsuspectingly into this Randy's plan and all. I thought it was a fun, well-constructed horror comedy. Felt very episodic. You get these little, you know, scenes and such of the various victims that fall to Randy, and I loved the various different ways he dispatches people, as well as the characters. We do get a variety of characters within this film, so they're not just cookie cutter all the time. You know, some people stand up to him a little more. Some of them he actually kind of becomes an enamored with. So you run a whole gambit of different characters that show up in here. Now, it is on a lower budget, so there are those aesthetics in here. But what it doesn't have in budget, it makes up in entertainment, I think. And they do work well within their means and do some pretty creative stuff, especially with a reuse of an effects shot, which they do on purpose. I loved it. I love the fact it kept cropping up. But the only thing I would say is I wouldn't have minded maybe trimmed a bit. It does get a bit repetitious at a certain point. It didn't take me out of the film because, again, each one of these type of scenes that we get is interesting and different with a different group of characters, but still, maybe cutting out one or two of those I would have liked to see. But overall, I still found myself chuckling at this film, appreciating the wonderful looking practical special effects that they had in here, which they had some great stuff going on here. Let me tell you, it looked very gory and very disgusting, which it was supposed to be, and I mad props to their makeup department there for that. And it even has its own theme song with a music video at the end as well. And you can catch it right now on the YouTubes. I'll put a link down below, Auto Shop of Horrors. If you like your micro-budget type cinema horror comedy, I think you'll enjoy quite a bit. And that tune is kind of catchy as well. So check it out. If you do check it out, please leave your comments down below. Love to hear your thoughts on this independent horror comedy. Make sure you leave feedback for them as well. Constructive thoughts are always welcome. Check out our Patreon if you haven't already. I thank you for your support. And until next time, remember, keep that ticket stub.